Greetings, guys and gals. I'm Hound Dog 608, and welcome back to Let's Play The Colonel's Bequest. In the previous episode, we did some spying around the mansion. We found out that Gloria had some sort of medical problem, and she didn't trust Wilbur to keep it quiet. So we're going to go talk to him right now. And speaking of which, it looks like Gloria's here right now. This must be the library. You see many books of various and sundry topics displayed in the bookcases. Tucked into one wall, you notice an elevator shaft, which would make sense because there's an elevator upstairs, too.
I want to warn you, Wilbur. Don't you dare go spilling the beans on me.
I wouldn't do a thing like that, sweetie pie.
Okay.
My medical problem was my own business and nobody else's. See to it that you keep quiet.
Sure thing, whatever you say.
Okay, interesting. So Gloria doesn't seem to like Wilbur very much.
Fine.
Alright, let's take a look at Wilbur. Dr. Wilbur C. Fields is a pudgy man in his mid-50s. He seems to be a nervous type and sweats profusely. You wonder about his medical practices and if he ever samples his own wares. You gather that he has been the Colonel's personal physician for many years. What's he doing right now? Wilbur seems to be very interested in that magazine. What kind of magazine are we talking about here? Look magazine. Wilbur is reading a magazine, but you're not close enough to see it. Can we get a little closer to him and see what he's reading? You look over Wilbur's shoulder at the magazines and see pictures of racehorses. Okay. It's family-friendly, then. Let's look at the painting on the opposite wall here, too. Upon the wall opposite the fireplace hangs a portrait of a bloodhound, Beauregard, who we actually haven't met at this point, but Beauregard is the Colonel's dog. Strange. The dog's eyes are very black, almost hollow-looking. Yeah. Just like the rest of them, we can spy through this, room. They're black, almost hollow-looking, yeah. Okay, let's, talk to Wilbur a bit. Oops. I don't want to get right in front of him, though. But, yeah. Let's talk to Wilbur.
So you're Lillian's friend Laura, is it? You look very nice, Laura. Very nice indeed.
Dirty old man.
Oh, she's that kind of guy, okay.
Ah, my dear, come a little closer. I don't hear well.
Not on your life, I guess not.
You're very pretty, my dear. Now, don't be afraid.
Afraid you're not. Leery, yes. It's weird they have Laura's head here, because I think that's the narrator speaking, not her. Giving up on you, Wilbur goes back to his reading. Hold it, though. We're going to ask him a couple questions. Tell me about Gloria.
Gloria's a beautiful girl. A desirable girl. She was a patient of mine once, though I haven't seen her for quite some time.
Interesting. Can we ask him about Gloria's problem? Or is that too specific? The game does not understand problem. Okay. Well, let's ask about some other people we've met around the mansion. Now let's ask about Lillian.
I haven't seen Lillian for quite some time. I remember her visiting here as a child. I understand she had some problems a while back.
Problems? What do you mean by problems? Ask about problems? Does not understand problems. Okay, that's a shame. Ask about Ethel? What do you know about her?
Ethel and Henry were never close. As a consequence, I never saw much of them.
So, Ethel and the Colonel weren't close. What about Ethel and Lillian together? Anything about their relationship?
I understand that Ethel's had quite a time with that girl. Much of it was her own fault.
Okay, so they don't seem to get along. What about Rudy?
Rudy has no more morals than a rat. He has no right to pick on me.
Okay, so Wilbur doesn't like Rudy either, but what about Rudy and Gloria together? Because they are brother and sister.
Gloria shouldn't listen to her brother so much.
What else can we ask about her? What about Gertie? We heard about her. We haven't met her yet.
I'm not well acquainted with Gertrude. I know her daughter, though.
Yeah. Gertie is Gloria and Rudy's mother. Right. Okay. Clarence. We haven't met Clarence yet. What about him?
Sometimes Clarence gets a bum rap. He's not as bad as someone else. As some would have you think.
Okay, so he doesn't seem to mind Clarence. What about Clarence and Gloria, though? Because Gloria seemed to imply that they were in a relationship. But, she wanted to break up with him.
Clarence is sure smitten with her, alright.
What's that supposed to mean? So, she's not smitten with him, I'm guessing? Okay, oh yeah, we didn't even ask about the Colonel, did we?
Henry's got more life in him than you might think. Yes, sirree.
So he's still got lots of life in him, so If he does die, that would be very odd. Interesting. Good to know. What about the Colonel and Fifi, though? Because we were spying on them. It looked like they were romantically involved.
Can't blame them. No siree.
So, hold it. That means you like Fifi?
Ah, Fifi, wonderful girl, wonderful girl.
Yeah, he likes pretty women, I suppose. What about Jeeves?
I don't think much about Jeeves.
What about Jeeves and Fifi? They're both members of the staff.
What do I care about?
Okay, nothing there. What about the estate itself? Anything about it?
I come out here often to visit Henry. I don't like it at first, but the place can grow on you.
Yeah, I actually really like it, believe it or not. I really like the setting to this game. I think, is that all we can ask about right now? What about your bag?
Stay out of my bag, young lady.
Okay. What about racehorses? Because you were reading about them.
I don't know anything about it.
Hold it, though. What about just horses in general?
Looking at him now, you wouldn't believe he was a splendid animal at one time. I do love horses, you know.
I believe he's actually talking about the Colonel's horse, who we also haven't encountered yet. But, I'm not sure. Maybe I did.
I don't have anything else to say about that.
Okay, interesting. So the Colonel has a horse. We saw a picture of the Colonel's horse before, actually. So Wilbur seems interested in horses. He doesn't like Rudy, though. That's interesting. Oh, here we go. This appears to be the Colonel's study, as a large desk dominates the room. Upon the desk, you notice a small glass case. At the back of the room, two large cabinets also catch your attention. What's in that case? You look through the small glass case and notice a little silver derringer mounted upon a blue velvet backing. A gun, okay. Can we open this cabinet over here? Cabinet, yeah, whoops. What's inside? You carefully open the glass door of the cabinet and look inside. Stored within it is the Colonel's rifle collection. Okay, so there's rifles in this one. Can we look at those spears up there? Two African spears hang crossed above the fireplace. What about this head? A huge rhino head hangs above the fireplace. Two spears. What's this? A stuffed alligator. Okay. And a stuffed eagle. Interesting. Can we look in the fireplace? Is there any secret passages in there? The finely carved fireplaces show the craftsmanship of bygone days. Is there a painting in here? A picture is a picture. Nothing of interest. Okay, I don't think there's any spyable things in here. What about this cabinet? Cautiously, you peek inside the open door of the cabinet. Not surprisingly, part of the Colonel's weapons collection is housed there. Within the cabinet, you see an Australian boomerang, a steel cutlass, a pearl-handled dagger, a mace, and an antique crossbow. You're going to want to keep a note of those, because if any of those should happen to go missing, we're going to want to know what goes missing. Just some food for thought there. It also appears there's a globe down here. You see a large globe in the corner of the study. Can we spin the globe? Yeah, you can. It serves no purpose, but you can do it. Interesting. Okay. So we've seen the Colonel's weapons collection. Gee, you feel a little dizzy now. That reminds me, when I was a kid, I remember... Oh yeah, but I forgot that Fifi was even here. Busily cleaning the Colonel's study. When I was a kid, we had a globe, and we thought that if we spun the globe, we would actually spin the real Earth. It's funny. Fifi doesn't have time for idle chit-chat. Okay, so I'm guessing we can't ask her about anything. Yeah, okay. I won't put the testimony music on there, or the cross-examination music. So, I guess now, we've seen the Colonel's weapons collection. I'm looking at my notes here, what we still need to see. Oh, here's Jeeves. Would you like a drink?
No, thank you.
Can we look at Jeeves? Jeeves is the Colonel's imposing butler. Though you find him somewhat good-looking, he nevertheless gives off a disconcerting feeling of secretiveness. You've noticed that Jeeves generally keeps to himself and seems to talk in little more than monosyllables. You wonder about him. Can we talk to Jeeves right now? You attempt to talk to Jeeves, but he ignores you as he goes about his business. But what about a drink, man? What if I want a drink? Oops. Ask about drink. No, he ignores you. Why does he offer stuff to Wilbur, but not to us? That's kind of fair. Can we look at the bookcases here? The bookcases are crammed full of books. Can we look at what types of books? Wilbur was reading a magazine. You see some books on the table. Huh. I guess not. Okay. Interesting, though, nonetheless. I forget, did we look at the painting here? Yeah, it was Beau Rivard. Okay. Cool. There also seems to be, like, a cannon and a horse up here. Various objects and knickknacks are displayed on the fireplace mantle. None of it interests you, though. Okay. Anything interesting with the shaft? Currently, you don't see an elevator, just an elevator shaft. Okay. Interesting. Is anybody... I'll save here, actually. It's been a while since I've saved. Is there anything in the billiards room right now? I don't think so. And if there isn't, I can use the secret passage. Oh, Gloria's here.
Would you like a drink?
No, thank you.
So she's just listening to music? Look at Gloria. Oop, Gloria, whoops. Gloria has a dreamy look on her face as she listens to the music playing on the Victrola. Can we talk to Gloria right now? I'm actually not sure if we can. It appears Gloria is more in a mood to listen to music than to talk to you. Can I ask her about things, though? No, okay, I didn't think so. She's just chilling, listening to music, that's okay. Let's go to, the parlor. We haven't been in here yet. You've entered the parlor of the old mansion. Against the back wall, you notice a sculpted marble bar, and in the corner, a parrot swings from its bird stand. And is now 7:45, okay, so 15 more minutes and the act's over. Interesting. That old... Oh, I'm not sure what voice to give Clarence.
Shh, he's that young friend of Lillian's.
I was thinking of actually giving Clarence a Miles Edgeworth voice, because if we look at him, I believe he actually is an attorney. Clarence Sparrow is a dapper-looking man in his late 40s. From what you have gleaned, he has been the Colonel's attorney for some time. Yes, there you go. And he seems to know the rest of the group as well. His manner's a bit on the curt side, and you sense a bit of sneakiness here. Look at him again. Clarence seems to be having a heated discussion with Gertie. Can we look? He seems to be smoking as well. That's a big cigar. Let's look at Gertie. We haven't really talked to her yet. Gertrude Dijon is the Colonel's widowed sister-in-law. She is obviously behind the times, as she looks like she's stepped out of the gay 90s, which is a term for the 1890s, because this is 1925, so it wouldn't refer to the 1990s. A bit of a snob, she walks around with her nose up in the air and has an annoying habit of constantly playing with her many strands of pearls. Alright, what are you guys doing here? Can we talk to them? Talk to Gertie. Not sure what kind of voice to give her, because her and Ethel, I think, have very similar voices. So.
Please leave us be, Laura. We're having a private discussion here.
Excuse me.
It'd be best if you left, Laura. Please go, Laura.
Okay, same thing here. Hold it, though. Let's do some investigating here. Ask about the Colonel.
Don't let him fool you, Miss Beau. He may look like a doddering old man, but he knows exactly what he's doing. I don't believe he intends on giving us, any of us, one thin dime. He's got some plan of his sleeve, mark my words.
Interesting. What about Fifi?
I can tell you this much, Miss Beau. Fifi isn't doing much cleaning around here.
What about Jeeves? Is he doing things?
He's only the butler. Why would I care about him?
Well, in mystery stories, it's often the case that the butler did it, so I wouldn't rule him out. What about Ethel?
Oh, her. My sister-in-law's nothing but an old sloppy drunk. She's made nothing but a mess of her entire life.
What about Ethel and Lillian together? That's one important thing you have to ask about people together.
Gloria and I get along superbly. Nothing like Ethel and her daughter.
Hold it. What about your daughter? What about Gloria?
I'm so proud of my daughter. She's a very talented actress, you know.
What about your son, Rudy?
My son has a good head for business, and he's very handsome, don't you think?
What about the Colonel and Fifi together? Oops, I keep making typos.
None of us are a bit fond of her. We know what she's after.
Is money, maybe? Maybe she's a gold digger, I don't know. Hold it, what about... How about we continue questioning next time, because we're almost at 15 minutes. We'll see you next time, folks. Let's spy on these people.